Hello dear viewers, welcome back to Medchem Companion channel. Today we will discuss stereochemistry of cetirizine. Cetirizine is a drug of class antihistamines, and antihistamines are also known by the name anti-allergic compound. Means this cetirizine is used in the treatment, or we can say in the management of what? Allergic reaction. What are antihistamines? How they are classified? It is already covered in previous lecture. Today we will discuss what is the difference between cetirizine and its another enantiomer, levocetirizine. Before going deep into their differentiation, we first understand what is cetirizine. So cetirizine is nothing but it is a racemic mixture. Racemic mixture means what? Racemic mixture is nothing but it is a equal mixture of levo and dextro isomers. What do you mean by levo and dextro isomers? Means cetirizine, this cetirizine which is usually available in the market in various branded form, this cetirizine is nothing but it is a mixture of levo and dextro isomers. So what do you mean by levo and dextro? So levo means those isomer which rotates plane of polarized light towards left direction are known by the name levo isomer, and dextro isomer are those isomer which rotate the plane of polarized light towards right direction. So which one is levo and which one is dextro? So levo isomer of cetirizine is known by the name this levocetirizine, and dextro isomer of cetirizine is known by the name this dextrocetirizine. It means this dextrocetirizine rotates the plane of polarized light towards where? Right direction. And this levocetirizine rotates the plane of polarized light towards left direction. So this cetirizine is nothing but it is a mixture of levocetirizine and dextrocetirizine. Remember, the cetirizine tablet which are consuming daily by so many people, it is actually a mixture of levocetirizine and dextrocetirizine, and it is chemically it is denoted by three symbol, plus minus, small d and small l, or SR and RS. Now the question arises, if this cetirizine is a mixture of levo and dextro, and levo rotate plane polarized light toward left and dextro rotate plane polarized light toward right, why these two enantiomer rotates the plane of polarized light in opposite direction? Why? The answer resides in its structure. First we will see in levocetirizine. Levocetirizine has following structure. This is the structure of levocetirizine, and here this is the structure of dextrocetirizine. Now in levocetirizine and dextrocetirizine, what is the difference? The difference is only in the position of this hydrogen. Here this hydrogen, here this hydrogen. All the other parts of these molecules are similar, means both of them are same structure, that's why they are isomer. But the difference is only in the position of this hydrogen. Here the hydrogen is placed below the plane because it is represented by, that's why it is represented by dash like notation. And here the hydrogen is placed above the plane, above the plane, that's why it is represented by this wedge line. This is the only difference, and due to this difference, due to this hydrogen which is placed above this whole molecule, due to this the hydrogen which is placed below this whole molecule rotate the plane polarized light towards left, and because here hydrogen is present above the plane, this whole molecule rotates the plane polarized light towards right direction. If it is true that this cetirizine is a mixture, then why we are now consuming levocetirizine? Now why only levocetirizine drugs are widely marketed and used by so many people? why this levocetirizine is nowadays prescribed by doctors? Again, the answer is here. This levocetirizine has strong anti-allergic activity, but this dextrocetirizine have weak anti-allergic activity. Means this cetirizine have both enantiomer. In cetirizine, this dextroisomer is also present and levoisomer is also present, but only this levocetirizine isomer or this levoform or this levorotatory cetirizine is only responsible for its anti-allergic activity. This dextrocetirizine have very weak anti-allergic activity, or we can say this dextroform has no activity, very minimal activity. So when it comes to the knowledge of chemist, that only levoform is important, only levoform is possessing this strong anti-allergic activity, then why we are consuming this dextroform? It's useless. That's why what happened today, this cetirizine, which is a mixture, this mixture is again separated into its levoform. In which form? Levoform. And this levoform, that's why this levoform is separated, purified, and this this levoform is currently marketed in that. This levoform is usually, or only this levoform is marketed nowadays. Now we have to find out the exact configuration of this carbon and this carbon, because this is the only carbon which is chiral in this whole molecule. So in order to find out, or in order to denote a specific configuration to this carbon, we have to apply SCF rule over here and find out the exact configuration. So on this carbon there are four valency. This carbon is directly attached to nitrogen, directly attached to this carbon of this chlorophenyl ring, and directly attached to this carbon of phenyl ring. Now among this nitrogen, carbon and carbon, nitrogen has highest atomic number, that's why first priority given to this nitrogen. This carbon and this carbon both are same, but here chlorine is present, that's why this carbon is given second priority and this carbon is given third priority. Fourth priority goes to this hydrogen. Now again we apply the SCF rule. We draw an arrow from 1 to 2 and 3. So this arrow moves in this fashion. It means it is clockwise. And if it is clockwise, then the configuration of this carbon may be R. Now we have to look at the position of lowest priority group. As we have seen in previous classes, if the lowest priority group is present below the plane, then configuration remains as such. It means this carbon has R configuration. So levocetirizine is what? Levocetirizine is nothing but it is a R isomer. Now here this carbon also connected by same group. First priority goes to nitrogen, second to this, third to this carbon. So again here arrows moves in this fashion, means it is clockwise, and it is clockwise, that's why this carbon may have R configuration. Now we have to look at the lowest priority group, which is hydrogen, and hydrogen is placed here above the plane. And we have seen in previous classes, if lowest priority group is present above the plane, the configuration changes from R to S. That's why here the carbon has which configuration? S configuration. That's why this dextroisomer is also known by the name S isomer. It means S isomer has very weak anti-allergic activity and R isomer has very strong anti-allergic activity. That's why nowadays we generally use levocetirizine in place of cetirizine, which is a mixture of both these compounds. I hope you understand the concept. नेक्स्ट वी विल सी सेकंड मॉलिक्यूल ऑफ स्टीरियो आइसोमर्स विच इज अवेलेबल इन द मार्केट. थैंक यू.